I'm Chase, and this is
Ash,
and we are part of Glam and Cheese.
Captains of Cheese. We're gonna make some toasties.
Sweet.
So what are we gonna make first, Chase?
We're gonna make our infamous herb butter, all freshly pillaged from the garden.
The herbs, that is, not the butter or the bread. So what are we gonna do now, Chase?
Chuck some garlic in a mortar and a pestle. Mm-hmm. Add a whole bunch of little capery buddies. Add some salt. And smash it. Add a whole bunch of dill. Mm. A little bit more dill. Dill's kind of the winner. Some
rosemary. I thought you were going to reveal like the secret recipe.
No. Dill's just a friend.
Just a friend.
We're just friends.
Friend of cheese.
Some sage. And smash these guys up as well.
Not so good.
And some oregano, just get rid of the bugs. Some parsley. Some gorgeous thyme.
Gorgeous.
Bit more parsley. And fuck it, a bit more rosemary.
Now this does depend on what we have in the garden.
Yeah.
What time
spring
of year it is.
Spring onion greens. And smudge it all together.
Smudge it. Oh yeah, you gotta make a real mess of this. That's the secret.
So you gotta mush them up pretty good. Because it's not fun to get like a whole piece of rosemary in your mouth.
It doesn't look good on the dance floor. You get a bit of green hanging out of your face.
No. A little bit of gorgeous seeded mustard.
Gorgeous.
A little bit more salt for good measure. Squeeze of lemon juice.
Gorgeous cheese. Still is the most important part.
After glam.
After glam. First glam, then cheese.
And a whole bunch of deliciously spreadable, not spreadable, real butter, but at room temperature butter.
Spreadable too.
So hot summer's day butter is the exact temperature for this recipe. Mix it up. Mix it. This also works for garlic bread.
Garlic bread tastes good.
Yeah.
What kind of cheese have you got in your
taste soup? We got some Australian tasty cheddar. You want something with a little bit of flavour, but because you're adding a whole bunch of salt, you can even use shitty cheese and it still works out pretty good. If you're grilling on a barbecue, chuck it on the outside of the toasty, but if you're in a gorgeous little sandwich press, on the inside.
Now, if you have to ask, should you use more butter, you should always use
yes.
more butter.
The answer is always yes.
More.
Let's do both.
Yeah.
Because the answer is always
more
butter.
Mm.
Some people might say this is too much butter, and we say get out of my house. Chuck it on.
Oh, the best, yeah.
A nice hot sandwich press,
hot.
Obviously. Hot.
Pre-prepared. Chuck the peas on. Oh, yes.
We can be heroes.
Oh,
it's
so good.
There you go.
Okay, the secret is to not lift up the press.
That's the secret. And that butter's going to drip off the edge in a minute.
Oh, yeah.
Could you grab? It's going to drip on the fabric. All right.
That's just looking sensational.
We ready?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you.
Might let that cool down for a little bit so we don't burn our tongues.
Yeah. Yeah.